everyone. This is Holly Knutson. It's been a while since I recorded a video, but I am a holistic cancer coach and FDN from Utah. And since it's summertime, I want to talk about how to use cistus tea to repel ticks. Well, now that it's summer, we're all outside for barbecues and pool parties, or at the lake or in the canyons. But unfortunately, annoying bugs and insects are also part of the picture. But what if I told you that drinking a special type of tea could make you inhospitable to mosquitoes, ticks, and other flying creatures you'd rather not deal with while enjoying the great outdoors? Make yourself naturally repellent to pests by brewing up a batch of cistus tea. And this is super easy, and I'm going to teach you how to do it in today's video. But first, what is cistus tea? Well, cistus incanus, also called Mediterranean rock rose, comes from Sardinia, an island off the coast of Italy. It also grows in Greece and Turkey. Cistus is an evergreen shrub that is bursting with gorgeous purplish-pinkish flowers against greenish-grayish leaves. The tea is popular in Europe, but is only recently gaining notoriety here in the States. Cistus is a great alternative to caffeinated teas, has a mellow, pleasant flavor, and is safe for pets to ingest. The tea is used as an affordable and simple remedy to treat a host of chronic illnesses. Studies have shown it to be effective against some of the worst retroviruses. And I did do a video on retroviruses. And these different viruses include HIV, Ebola, influenza, and Borrelia. And that's the spirochete associated with Lyme disease. Cistus is also used to treat persistent bacterial infections and mold. So it's quite the multitasker. How does cistus tea repel insects? Cistus tea, which can be used as an all-natural insect repellent, is loaded with bioactive compounds, including bioflavonoids, polyphenols, catechins, rutin, proanthocyanidins, and gallic acid. And because it grows in the dry, arid, harsh climate of the Mediterranean, the cistus plant protects itself by increasing its levels of polyphenols. And these are powerful constituents that fight oxidative stress in the body and free radical damage. Polyphenols are naturally occurring phytochemicals that act as antioxidants to improve health by impacting gene expression and favorably influencing the microbiome and immune system. Aside from protecting you from insects, the tea also reduces inflammation, breaks down viruses and biofilms, and stimulates detoxification. Cistus tea is a powerful non-toxic remedy for urinary tract infections, PCOS, and leaky gut, along with being a potent remedy for treating Lyme disease, which is renowned for being difficult to treat. This multitasking tea is beneficial on many levels, and it certainly beats using synthetic repellents like DEET that are full of toxic chemicals that go directly into the bloodstream when applied to the skin. Cistus contains components that insects find irritating in terms of how it smells. And since insects are sensitive to the smell, and we humans don't detect the odor, they'll steer clear of you. And this will protect you not only from irritating mosquitoes, but from potential tick bites and the diseases they cause, including Lyme disease, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, and even tick-borne encephalitis. As a side bonus, cystus tea also whitens teeth because it's able to break down biofilms, which are colonies of slimy microorganisms that encase themselves in a protective covering or shell. And this outer encasement protects the organisms, which is one reason infections can be so difficult to treat. And this is why biofilm busters are often used before a bacterial or pathogen treatment protocol is initiated. Biofilms can form on the teeth as dental plaque, and this causes teeth to yellow. If you follow these instructions that I'm about to give you, cystus tea will restore your teeth back to their original whiteness without using toxic chemicals. So all you need to do is take a couple of swallows of tea and swish it back and forth for a minute or so to begin breaking down biofilms that have formed on your teeth. And do this consistently until your teeth are restored to their natural whiteness. Or, alternatively, you can use a little dropper and place a few drops of the tea on your toothbrush and brush for a minute to gently break down plaque. And keep repeating this process until all the plaque is broken down and your teeth are brilliantly white again. Then use the tea once a week or so to maintain the whiteness. So here's how you make cystus tea. Traditionally, the tea is brewed three times, but if you want to circumvent having to brew it multiple times, simply follow this recipe that I'll tell you right now, but I'll also put it up on the screen and you can screenshot it. Directions: boil 1 liter of filtered water, and please don't use tap water. The mineral content will be problematic. Then add 1 tablespoon of cystus tea to the water that should be between 170 and 190 degrees Fahrenheit. So use a thermometer to make sure that the temperature falls within that 170 to 190 degree range. And I'll put links to buy cystus tea underneath the video. Now, once you've added the tea, you're going to want to steep it for at least 35 minutes. And please make sure the lid is kept on the tea to preserve the volatile oils from escaping. Now, what I do to keep the tea so it's not just floating in the water is I get these little tea bags, and I'll put a link for these too, and I put the heaping tablespoon of the tea in this little bag, and then I fold it over 2 or 3 times and place it in the water to steep. Once the tea is steeped for about 35 minutes, you can either start drinking it then or put it in the fridge. It's also really nice to drink cold. It has a very pleasant taste, and it's not going to be something you dread drinking. You're going to want to aim for about 2 cups of tea per day for a minimum of a week to make yourself insect repellent. And you can add a little lemon, whole leaf stevia, or honey to the tea if you prefer a splash of sweetness. Be sure and store the tea in the fridge, and you can heat it up if you want to drink it warm, or you can enjoy it as an iced tea beverage. To provide additional repellent protection, you can pour the tea into a spray bottle and spray it directly onto your skin or clothing. Or you can also spray it directly into the air around you if you're actively being attacked. If you'll be using the tea in this way, you can use less water during preparation so the concoction is stronger. Now remember, the tea is safe to give to pets. Providing protection to your pets indirectly protects you and your family from insects as well, because they won't bring them in the house. And as we all know, animals often do bring fleas and ticks or whatever they're exposed to into the house, which will expose you and the entire family to whatever they bring in. To protect cats and dogs from ticks and other insects, you can mix a little of the tea that you just made in with their water, or actually crush the tea itself into a fine powder and sprinkle a little bit on their food. And do this consistently to keep them safe from pests. Approximately 1 teaspoon of the tea for every 10 pounds of body weight should do the trick. You can also buy cistus tea in capsule form if you'd rather do that than brewing up a batch of tea. If you're going to go that route, just open the capsules and sprinkle the powder onto your pet's food. And that's probably about a teaspoon. In summary, cistus is a medicinal tea that will not only repel all those nasty insects that can ruin your summertime fun, but it will also strengthen immunity, break down biofilms, decrease inflammation, and promote detoxification. The tea is retroviral, meaning it contains numerous antiviral compounds that prevent viruses from attaching to the surface of cells. And this is a big deal because viruses are notorious for being hard to treat. And that's because we can't use antibiotics to treat viruses like we can bacteria, because viruses are intracellular. And this is of particular importance during this time when we've lost so many people to COVID-19. Don't wait to brew up a batch of this magical potion to protect yourself, your family, and your pets. Have you heard of cistus tea? Let me know in the comments, along with any questions you have. Thanks so much for watching.